Hello and welcome. In this video, I'll be showing you how to make some terracotta pots in Blender using a really easy technique. Enjoy. Okay, so I have a new file in Blender, and I'm just gonna go ahead and select a general file. So we have a brand new scene open in Blender. And I'm just gonna start out by deleting everything by hitting A and then typing delete. And then I'm gonna add in a curve. So I'm gonna hit Shift A and then I'm gonna go to curve and then Bezier curve. And now we have a nice curve. So I'm gonna hit tab to go into edit mode. And then I'm gonna tap delete and then I'm gonna select segments. And then I'm just gonna go into side view and right here in the toolbar, I'm going to select the draw option, and then I am going to draw a basic pot shape, kind of like this, and then I'm going to go over to the modifier section, and I'm going to hit add modifier and select screw, and now we have a low poly pot, and it's a little bit too low poly. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna add modifier and I'm gonna select the subdivision surface modifier. And what this is gonna do, it is going to smooth out our pot here. And now at this point, it's very important that we make the material so that we don't have to drag and drop the material onto every single pot that we make. So I'm gonna go to the shading tab right here. And now we're in the shading tab, but I'm going to go ahead and hit number pad period key to focus in on the object. And then I am going to go into rendered view. And I'm just going to go up here and turn off the UI right here. And I'm going to go into the render properties. And under render engine, I'm going to change this to cycles. And then I'm gonna go right here to the world properties. And right here, I'm gonna select this color thing and I'm gonna change it to environment texture. And I put a link to an HDR in the video description. So go ahead and download that or you can get your own HDR by yourself. But anyway, I'm gonna get that HDR right here. Which is right here. And now we have this nice HDR, but I'm gonna go back to the render properties and under film, I'm gonna click the transparent property. And now we have a nice HDR right here. And this is going to be very good to us in this tutorial. And now we can start making the material. So right here, I'm gonna click this thing and I'm gonna select material and then I can click this and rename it to pot material and then hit enter. And now we have a nice basic setup right here. And I'm gonna hit Shift A and I'm gonna search for a noise texture. And then I'm gonna add in the noise texture and I'm gonna drop it about right here. And then I'm gonna hit Shift A again, and I'm gonna search for a color ramp. I'm gonna drop this in right here. And I'm gonna hit Shift A one more time, and I'm gonna add in a bump node. So the first thing that I wanna do is I'm gonna select the factor from the noise texture, and I'm gonna put it into the factor of the color ramp. And then I'm gonna take that same factor from the noise texture and plug it into the height in the bump node. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the color from the color ramp and I'm gonna plug it into the base color. I'm gonna take the normal from the bump and plug it into the normal in the principled BSDF right here. And this is gonna look super weird and that's because we haven't given enough data to go off of. So up here in the edit preferences, I'm going to be enabling the Node Wrangler add-ons, so I can just search for Node and Node Wrangler, so just enable that. And with the Node Wrangler enabled, I'm gonna hit Control, Shift, and then left click on the noise texture to preview it. And you can see we have, it's kinda hard to see everything, so I'm gonna go to the color ramp, Control, Shift, and click on the color ramp. And then I'm gonna slide this up so we can see this in more detail. And speaking of detail, on the noise texture, the detail is going to go all the way up to 15. So we have a very detailed texture. And the roughness is going to go all the way up to 1. So we have an even more detailed texture. And then the scale is going to come up as well. It's going to come up to about right here. And now we can start to put in our colors. So with this black slider selected, I'm going to hit the black color and I'm going to change this to kind of this color. And the hex value is 47321F. And that's my hex value. I apologize for my cat. One second. All right, the cat's gone and we can continue this. So we're going to select the white slider, and we're gonna change this color to be kind of a darkish red right here. And this needs to be redder. Red, because we're making a nice red pot. I can kind of change this too. And the hex value for this is going to be B04341. And now we have this nice pot texture right here. And if we control shift and click on the principal BSDF, we can see that we have a nice and way too shiny pot. So yeah, that pot's too shiny. So we're gonna go down here and we're gonna turn the roughness up right here, and I'm going to change it to 0.7, and I'm just going to shade smooth this object just in case. I think it was already shaded smooth, but it wasn't acting like it. But anyway, we now have this, but if we control shift and click on the bump node, we can see that this is very much bump. There is a lot of bump in this bump node. So under the strength, I'm gonna change this. I'm gonna turn this down right here. And now it's a lot more subtle. So I'm gonna go back to rendered view. Oh, and I'm control shift and click on the principal BSDF. And we have a very nice pot now. And that's the end of the texturing. So I can go back to layout and we can start making some more pots. And the way I'm gonna do that is I'm gonna hit Shift D and then X, and I'm just gonna move it along the X axis. And then I'm going to tab into edit mode and I'm gonna hit delete and select segments. And then I can draw my pot right here. So I'm gonna make kind of like a vase right here. And then, and now I have kind of this interesting pot shape right here. And if we go into rendered view, we can see that it has the same texture as this pot. And what I can do is I can just make a lot of different stuff right here. So I can just keep hitting Shift D and tab into edit mode and then hit delete and segments. And I can kind of make some interesting designs like this. I kind of have a cool looking thing to it. And this HDR that we installed puts a lot more into it. You have some nice, beautiful pots right here. And You can texture it in different ways. You don't have to texture it with this exact material, but this is the one that I'm going to be using. And I can just make kind of a thing right here. We have an interesting kind of flask here. And you can see that they are all in the same material right here. So I'm just gonna keep making a bunch of these. And now that I have a lot of pots right here, you can basically do whatever you want with them. You can put them on a nice kind of shop, and that's basically it. So we have a really easy way to make a pot by just making a curve and then a screw modifier and subdividing it, which when combined with Blender's asset browser makes some very good results. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit like and subscribe, and I'll see you in another video. Bye.